Hello students, today I'm going to discuss you about one of the question paper which has been conducted recently in J&T University, that is the Biostatistic and Research Methodology Form D fourth year. This time in university exam we have got the lot of theory questions. Yes students, only two problem it was there in the question paper. So let us review what kind of question paper it was there. So this is the question paper for biostatistic and research methodology, right? So since the COVID rule it is not going on, so you need to attempt 5 questions out of 8 questions, and at the time it was provided 3 hour for 70 marks. So here we can see into the question number 1, that is the write about the following pure theory question. Students, this is the clinical study design or interventional studies, right? So when it comes to the interventional studies, what are the things you are supposed to write here? Already we have discussed into the regular classes, and the video also it is there in the my channel. Clinical trials, what are the different types of controlled trials, or different types of randomized controlled trial, non-randomized controlled trial, before and after study, factorial design, crossover study. Those are the things you are supposed to write here for 7 marks. So the second beat of the first question, it is determination of sample size, right? So when we are going for the doing any kind of research, we need to determine the sample size. So what are the different methods that you are going to write here for 7 marks? The first, for example, use of formula. We are determining different formulas are available to determine the sample size. Then ready-made tables are also available to determine the sample size. Nemograms are available, and the different computer software also we are using to determine the sample size. So very simple question, 7 plus 7, 14 marks, right, student? Coming to the second question, that was the write in brief about following. The first one, it is the first bit, report writing of scientific data, right? For this also, the nice class it has been taken. You can see into the video, report writing of scientific data means how we are going to write formal report, informal report, informal report, what are the content like title, table of content, abstract, introduction, literature of review, different findings, discussion, conclusion, that what are the content, how we are going to write the report. Those are the things you are supposed to write for 7 marks. Second bit in the second question, that is the method of presentation of data. How to present the data? Data presentation, it is there in the second unit of your syllabus. That data presentation, what are the textual data presentation, tabular data presentation, diagrammatic data presentation. In diagrammatic, like histogram, pie charts, or different types of graph it is there, right? So those pie bar diagrams and those things you are supposed to write for 7 marks. Third question, write a note on following merits and demerits of median, mean mode, median you have read. So what are the advantages of median? What are the disadvantages of median? That you can describe purely theory. You can write about the formula. Variance, you can write about the variance for 5 marks, and standard error of mean, right? What are the standard error? So that you can write for the another 5 marks. Pure theory, no need to have, only you need to describe the things. Coming to the fourth question, write short note on following SAS, right? The clinical SAS, the software for that also class it has been taken. You can go for null hypothesis. What is the null hypothesis? What is the assumption when we are starting any research? What is the meaning of this one? Then Wilcoxon sign rank test, that also you need to describe, and you have to write the formula, what the formula it has given in this particular test. Coming to the fifth question here, write in a detail about patient record database management. Add note on a relative risk and attributable risk, right? So this is also pure theory questions for the 14 marks that you can write, that we have discussed in the regular classes. Videos are available. Sixth question, write about the following level of significance. What are the level of significance? Probability 0.01 level of significance, 0.05 level of significance. What is the, how, whenever you got any finding, what is your level that you need to describe here? You have to explain here, right? Right, whether your work is worth fully or not. What are the false, 95% population it is false, or 5% of it is the true, what that you have to explain here. Advantages of computerized literature, retrieval, right? Whenever any of the things which has been stored into the digital media or into the computer, how we are, it is going to be advantageous in long term, that you can describe for 7 marks. Nice question. Here in 7th question, there was the problem, that is the very simple problem it has given, that you can attempt. Definitely this can be a scoring question. The calculate regression line y on x for the following data, right? So this already you have habituated, like x, y, you have to go for the x, y, y, i, and you can divide it into the, that in the given formula. Write a note on z test. That also z test to determine two populations means are different when the variance are known. What is, why it is useful? To determine two populations means are different when a variance are known and the sample is large in size, right? That you can write for the 4 marks, very simple. Coming to the this one here, calculate mean for the following frequency distribution. Mean also, you are very much familiar about the mean, how we are going to write 10 into 1, 10, 9 into 4, 36, like that. You can go x, I, f, y, and you can put into the formula, you will get the value. Very simple problem. Explain about the correlation coefficient and it's important. Again, theory, it's supported by this, right? The correlation coefficient, you are very much familiar. It is also known as Pearson's correlation coefficient. Like, it is for the measure of linear correlation between two sets of data, right? And it's so important wherever it is useful, that you can write down, right? So this is very simple question, students. You can score very good, no need to worry about the passing mark. But last year, compared to last year, when there was the 8 question, in a maximum 75% it was the problems only. So by seeing the question paper, students, they scared, then they came into the pressure into their mind and they could not attempt very well. But this time I hope you people might have written very well manner, right? So further, those who are the coming batches, they can go for here the in slides here. Also, I have kept all of my important slides related to these subjects, and in YouTube channel also link that I will provide into the description. That also you can go. These videos are already made and it is uploaded. It will get you, by seeing those videos, you will get the lot of ideas. So since these subjects, it is creating lot of pressure among the students. So you can have the idea. All the best. Thank you.